DaVinci Resolve's new audio transcription feature is insane. Within seconds, it can analyze all of the audio from your footage, making it effortless to generate subtitles for your YouTube videos or for your shorts. So let's jump right into it.
Once you've added your footage to use in the media pool, all you need to do is right-click on the file and come down to Audio Transcription, and then you'll see a subsection open up, and we're simply going to click Transcribe. DaVinci is now analyzing every bit of audio from your file, and then right before your eyes, a window appears containing all of the transcribed text. Pretty cool.
One thing to note though, I found it to be generally quite accurate for most transcriptions, however, please do read through it all carefully, especially if you mention any shortcuts in your audio, for instance, Command or Control plus I. The plus will not be included as a symbol, but it will actually use the word plus instead. Also, I didn't mention people's names in this audio file, however, I do believe that it can struggle at times, especially for those names that are a bit more obscure, so this is just something to be aware of. It won't always be 100% accurate.
Now that we've got our transcribed audio in text form, let's take a look at what we can do with it. If you click in your text anywhere within the window, the red audio playhead will automatically jump to that point within your audio. This is really useful if you'd like to find out the time at which you start talking about a particular topic, for instance. Another cool feature is that you can search for certain words that you've mentioned within your audio by just clicking the search icon at the top of the window and typing your word. If I type shortcut, for example, it's showing me that this word is mentioned two times, and I can cycle through them by clicking the forward and back arrows just here. If you suddenly realize that a word is misspelt or that you'd like to change it, you can just click in the field that says replace with and type your new word in, followed by clicking on the replace button to replace just that one word that you've got highlighted, or click replace all if you'd like to change all of the highlighted words to your new word. It's so simple, yet effective and time-saving. The transcription also highlights your silent portions or gaps in audio, if you like, which are marked with the three dots within the two brackets just here. If this is something you'd like to remove, it can be done very simply by coming up and selecting the three dots at the top right of the transcription window here and clicking Remove Silent Portions. If you find that the text that's been generated is too small or too large, you can adjust this very easily by clicking on the Decrease or Increase Font Size buttons just here. No need to squint the eyes or put the glasses on anymore.
Now, let's say there's a particular section of audio that you've recorded, or perhaps a cool quote that you've mentioned and you'd like it to have it separated from your main audio track.
You can simply highlight the section of text in the transcription window and then come down to the bottom left and select the Create Sub Clip button. This will then give you the option to rename it, and once you're happy and click Create, it will show up as a new clip in your media pool like so, containing just the audio from your selected text. How quick and useful is that? You can also create markers for the selections of audio that you'd like to take note of by coming down to this blue tag icon. If you select the little down arrow beside it, you can actually change the color of the marker to one that's suited more to your own personal taste, and then click on the marker tab itself, which will insert it onto the timeline at the position your selected audio starts. At the bottom right of the window, we have two buttons. The left one is the Insert button, and the one to the right of that is the Append button. If we click on Insert, it will place your selected audio onto your timeline. If we click on the Append tool, it will simply add our audio portion to our timeline again, but this time at the very end of the audio track, whereas the Insert tool lets us place it wherever we liked within the track itself.
So you now know about all the features of audio transcription, but say you'd now like to export all of the generated text to a folder on your computer.
We can do this by clicking on the Export button at the top of the window here, and then it will give us the option to rename it and select the folder we'd like to save it to as a text file. This would be useful for then adding in subtitles or closed captions within YouTube without the need for you to manually type it all out. Instead, just copy and paste it in and you're good to go. Amazing!
Let me know in the comments how this tool will come in handy for you, as I do think that it will open up a number of useful outcomes for us all. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, with more DaVinci Resolve tutorials to come. Until the next time, have a great day.